Hello, hello, welcome everyone, and ahoy hoy. I know I haven't been present in quite a while, and it's a shame, but there's been a heck of a lot happening, and just it's touching to see the videos of well, videos, comments of people sort of saying, "Hey, Rob, you still exist at least. Hey, you're still alive, make some more videos and do something." But this is one. And it's more to sort of explain kind of what's going on, what's been going on, and just to sort of give a sort of a touch base on where I'm at. So yeah. Obviously there's the Dragon Age. Dragon Age campaign, and it got to the point of the War of the Axes, and then we pretty much had one session left to basically conclude the campaign, and effectively the group couldn't agree amongst themselves to go ahead and play that last session, as it were. And that's part of the thing with the inter relationship issues that we've kind of had partly there. I think that's a fair comment, that the group couldn't agree between itself to actually play the session. I don't think I'm waiting in too much like that, if any of the group's watching, to say, hey, no, Rob, it's not like that, it's such, or whatever. The fact that I'm even paranoid like that shows there's problems, right? And I suppose when you've got a group of people, you have the potential for those kind of issues where you can begin to get difficulties between one another. And I think it was starting to get to a point where members of the group were getting on each other's nerves too much. And we had one of the group that just like stopped coming, an integral part of the group, because he couldn't face sort of doing it with the issues he had with the dynamics of the group. So he had to drop out for a bit. And even though a willingness to finish the Dragon Age thing if need be, just to say, hey, closure, that's a wrap, this will be an epic thing to go out on. But I will close all that up in another video into how the Dragon Age thing actually ends, because bear in mind that even technically, what looks like no ending played at the table does actually create an ending. It's the absence of action actually leads to an interesting, unusual, unexpected kind of organic feeling ending to the campaign. So I'm here to declare the campaign ended. And there is something to explain to its end, and that will come in a video to follow this one. But just to sort of rationalize it, basically, what you'll be seeing is the absence of the session having played and the consequences of that absence. And it's more kind of a setup for, like, okay, who else could come then and try and take this on? And I would like to think that people in the community could say, oh, okay, that's a situation. That's created a situation now. I'm bringing that to my world, that situation, and my group of heroes are going to take that on as the second gen sort of thing. Or third gen, as it'd probably be at this point. Because we already had our second gen going in the alluvion, if you may recall. It was a long time ago, I know. But yeah, we got to a point where there was like too much bad feeling and like slight breakouts of hostility, and just the interpersonal relationship breaking down. And you know, there's a danger of that when you've got people. You may all be on board with gaming and RPGing in general, but all of that can really just burn you out with the system, or with the party, with the people, or it can just burn you out with RPG play just in general. You can just be so sickened of one experience that it's just burnt you out, and you just can end up saying, yeah, I just can't face that right now. Let's do something else. The thing for me is, like, when something like that happens, you know, I can turn to board games, I can turn to you know, miniature gaming and all that sort of thing, because especially the miniature gaming, that's actually my first passion. And then I came to RPGs from that. You know, it worked its way in from being a Warhammer Fantasy player to coming into Warhammer Fantasy role play. Yeah, which is why their Fated Travels was so big as it was, so involved, was because I was very passionate about Warhammer as a lore, and hence it was able to be portrayed through all of that. And Maestro's and Co's journey, you know, was kind of as it was, even though I wasn't the GM of that campaign, crazily enough. Yeah, so I know what the next two chapters of that would look like, you know, even though that wrapped the follow-on campaign, a setup to that, if it were to ever happen. But yeah, anyway, interpersonal breakdown, and we started Star Wars, you know, Edge of the Empire. I started GMing that, and you know, I made accommodations for the party, and I, you know, did a shit ton of research for the campaign. Because you know, everyone makes me for the big Star Wars fan and stuff, but I don't think I'm any bigger than a somewhat more than average fan. I'm not like a completely diehard. But what I went and did was go out and buy a lot of like literature and information on the series and do a lot of research on it. So I've got like the map book. It's just a book full of planets and information about the whole galaxy, and you know, I bought the Star Wars tourist guide thing with guides to bloody languages and things in it, so that I could get little phrases and words and drop them in, and little meanings and little things, little sort of things of import, even if the players can't sort of like get it, that's what they're encountering. You know, I'll know that I'm doing it as well as I can. The way my approach to RPGing, GMing, okay, is that you've sat down and you've started a session, and you have one chance in this life to actually run that session. If you think about it, you know, you won't be able to run that session again. I suppose you could do a Mark II with a different group, but you don't have that chance to run that session with that group anymore. So you have to make sure that you've put you're all into it, or at least that's how I feel. So I like to think that I've done everything I can, and it's an ideal, but it's never something that can actually be truly realized, like you know, you'd want it to be. But anyhow, yeah, there's just like difficulties in amongst the group. So the idea of meeting up necessarily didn't feel as enthralling as it should do, and you know, with people maybe hesitant to come along. And one of our number said, well, look, it's the summer months now, let's all enjoy this, the summer months, and then come back after that and we'll carry on Star Wars campaign or whatever. I could agree with that, and I think others probably secretly could have agreed with that. Just because the general sort of like It was just too much. So yeah, it took 2016 summer pretty much out of just meeting in general, like the whole way through. And then into once we got into like almost winter, we kind of got it back together again, to meet up and stuff. And it's been sort of like trying to find our feet, trying to find the way. I started to, I'd prepped and planned to bring Star Wars back in again. The problem was the gap in time through that summer. I know it doesn't mean anything to you guys that I was running Star Wars because I wasn't doing videos about it, Edge of the Empire. But it mattered to me that the many months of gap had actually created a problem in me where, like, my handle on it, my feel for I can't fudge through. I like to get all over it, all on top of it. I mean, there's the whole rules and there's the whole setting and there's the module and all those three strips. I like to integrate on top of and around like melted toffee. Yeah, I'm not just biscuit. Yes, I need to be toffee. And the time passes. And all that toffee, that's gone off somewhere else, or it's run away, it's melty, and so I'm left to approach it as biscuit, so I can't integrate in and around the gaps of those three strips of things. Yeah, I'm just left to place on top, and it's like, I'm trying, I'm coming at this, I'm preparing. It's like, hey, we're gonna do Star Wars again now. It's not summer anymore. Let's do this. But, even in my own head, I'm thinking, man, I don't have a handle like I did. And, that bothers me. So I'm not going to even enjoy GMing it as much. So I need to sort of dedicate the time to do that, to like reintegrate myself. But is it worth it? Like that, the instinct in your mind, is that going to be worth it? Because, we don't know how the group's going to be. So I decide what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a massive load of prep, but for a small thing. See that in my mind, that way I've kept it focused. Finish off the Teemo the Hutt stuff. Some of you that are familiar with it might know what I'm talking about there. So that the Teemo is basically and that's finished, and then a little sort of like thing that will follow that. But one of the players completely misunderstood what that meant, of like, hey, we're going to massively reduce the amount of sessions we play now. We'll just keep it very, very focused, and I'll do you a little thing here, and then we'll take breaks in between. I thought that was the whole campaign wrapped, and we haven't, we've only just finished off Teemo, for crying out loud. So player kind of committed suicide. See, have you ever been a GM and one of your players decides, I don't like my character anymore, so I'm just going to jump off this building or whatever, yes, we'll just roll a new thing or whatever. In fact, I don't even think I like the system. It's too complex. It's this, that, whichever, whatever sort of thing. So, I don't even know if I want to play, but I'm killing my character off. So I, as the GM, find that quite distressing that, someone would do that with their character, because even if the character ever meant something to them once, even if it doesn't anymore, the integrity of the world, surely, as a role-playing space, should surely be maintained. Of course, the player in question in my group's probably going to watch this and is going to feel that I'm getting at them, and that's again my paranoia. The whole group's social relationship lack of stability is, I think we're getting back on track, but I'm paranoid that I'm only one video away from a fucking massive row in some sort of way. But it's just what I think, others can weigh in and say if they agree with that or not with me on that, that it feels kind of harsh that you know that the integrity of the world of what you're going at isn't really maintained. So I can get that the player maybe is like, yeah, okay, you know, I kind of want to finish with the universe and drop out as a player, and that, you know, that's fine. There's still the possibility that the player may play, and we are running in an inclusive sort of manner that you know we want to try and not leave anyone out because they're all still part of our group in other stuff. What I mean is, like, it's not like the player's going to leave the group, sort of thing. So, like, we're looking at the moment of playing Blood Bowl, yeah, and that player in question, for example, may well, you know, come in and sort of play that with us. So it's not like that kind of cut. We're all part of that group, sort of thing, that meet, and then that group all just also then happen to do such and such RPG, and the same group also happen to play Dragon Age. So it's, you know, again, we'll get on to Dragon Age, but it's the same kind of thing that happened in regards to Dragon Age. The I'm getting bored or dissatisfied, or I don't think my character's going to prosper, or I don't think my character's going to win. See, I have to disagree with that again. Not looking for trouble, not looking for a fight. I only have to disagree from my point of view, and not say that the player is wrong, but disagree that I don't think there is a win or lose in RPGs. I think the win is having finished the story and basically said, yes, that's done, and yes, we enjoyed ourselves. But it depends what you as the player need to enjoy yourself. So if you are a player that feels that you have to have that, I want to be decked out in loot of an epic kind of what feels epic, and I want to have beat the last baddie and cleared the game. It's basically a computer game you're looking for at that point, with a bit of socializing. It's essentially you'd rather be playing WoW, really. But the problem with computer games is that A, they're restrictive, that they don't let the player do absolutely everything they want to do, and B, they call for a lot of repetition of the same content over and over again, known as farming, which, you know, is a joy killer. So, yeah. So there's been those issues, and then it's like, you know, that took all the wind out of my sails, so I couldn't finish push on with Star Wars yet. So, and we decided that one of the other players wanted to GM Through the Breach, which is the Malifaux World RPG. So I was going to be GMing that for the group. So, you know, I'm kind of going along in a sort of suck it and see kind of manner, because I don't know where my stance is right now on RPGs. I'm on the verge of becoming seriously jaded because of bad experiences. Even someone as crazy and passionate as you know I am about RPGs has the potential to become, you know, jaded in that fashion, and that's really that should highlight to you that the danger of degree of burnout, sort of thing, as it were, you know. And it could just be you need different kinds of experiences to heal that, not just time, but, you know, other kinds of thing. Hence me talking about, say, playing Blood Bowl for a few seasons of Blood Bowl, and, you know, something else, sort of thing, to try to pave over those cracks in the social relationships manner. Just doing the one thing as much as you are can kind of like push wherever the faults are, or what you perceive in each other to be faults, and in time begin to really highlight those. And I guess that's partly what kind of happened as well. So having not been taking part in games, and the social relations breakdown in the group, it was very hard to actually make videos about gaming when A, we weren't gaming, and B, my heart was very troubled. So the most honest thing I could have done would have been to make the video I'm making now, but that would have potentially caused problems had I did it then, because I was already kind of commenting on or hinting at some of the breakdown in the videos I was making then, and that was actually making the social relations worse, because obviously players were watching the videos, and it was like the interpretation of what I was saying was kind of anger or defensiveness or it just made it worse, basically. It just wouldn't have helped, basically. Yeah, I mean, I know a lot of you wanted updating and stuff, but that's kind of the best way that I can sort of explain it. Yeah, maybe with time, I'll be able to push on and carry on this Star Wars thing, or maybe it will come to pass that I just drop it completely. Maybe we'll carry on with Through the Breach, but we'll see how the dynamic of that goes. So the future is kind of unknown, really, what the future will be for like RPG videos and that sort of thing, because I don't want to feed you any bullshit and just like try and make videos because I can monetize them and like products and all this sort of thing out there. I don't want to just make it. I think the one thing that those of you that did follow me or do follow me passionately respected about what I did was that it was genuine and that it was passionate, and I think that's what you got on board with, and I don't want to give you really anything but that, so if that's not there, I don't want to give you anything that's insincere. So it's like I'm doing now, I'm talking to you and I'm being sincere and trying to sum up basically what happened there. Going forward, you will get the update, basically the end of Dragon Age, how that ends. And then we'll see what kind of videos I go forward to make, if any. A very strange point to be in, isn't it? So, until next time, hopefully I'll see you at the table.